Welcome guys to the third part of the K-Series build, and I hope at the end of this part we are gonna put a K-Series engine in either CRZ or a Honda Fit, and we will see. So let's get to it and prepare our engine to put that into the cars.
Okay, so before putting the new engine in, let me check on each side. And first one is just clean this RBP assembly. There's a small gauges inside. Just take them out, clean them with the brake cleaner. Look how clean it is after cleaning. Next is, if you have changed the steering pump with the idler pulley, just check this mark. This triangle should be between these two squares. This little triangle should be between these two squares. This one square, second square, and this should be exactly this. This is perfect belt and tension for this one. If this is not the case, you have to check your idler pulley or the belt. Okay, either one or this one is wrong. Either you have too tight belt or too loose belt, and either you have a faulty idler pulley. So then we come to this, and the transmission side, there very important, this pivot bearing, take the older one out if there it is, then put the new one in. And this is part number, this is a cheap one, and just put the new one with a key and hammer. Okay, so next is the clutch and flywheel. If you want to upgrade, that's your choice. This is my daily drive, that's why I choose the streetable one, the full disc one, instead of the puck clutch or the twin disc. Okay, so next, another mod. At this point I will recommend it, if you live in such countries where temperature does not fall to the minus in the winter, then you don't need this mod. So this will prevent heat from getting into your coolant. Okay, so almost 5 to 10 degree the engine will be colder. So for this mod, just remove this. This is the main radiator hose going into the radiator. So this is where your flywheel is. Okay, your transmission just above, just open this thing. Okay, just four nuts over there. Okay, and look at that. This is the part where cylinder 4 heat comes into this and heat up the coolant. Okay, so we don't want this. Just this is the screwdriver coming in cylinder 4. So just put a wool gauze in it or close it. Okay, this is where that all the exhaust was coming. Okay, so what I did was just buy a this stainless gauze, put it in there, and just put the thing back. Okay, next here would be throttle body. I recommend just use the stock throttle body, because the bigger throttle body will be so jerky. So if you are going turbo, no need for the big throttle body. And next is the map sensor. Still the Honda OEM one supports the 10 psi, so no need to change until you are running more boost. That covers this side. Now onto the front side. Here just change the intake manifold gasket. This one it's a phenolic gasket. The OEM one is the metallic gasket. This is a very nice mod, and I recommend doing it.
And remember, this is there is a water housing over there. So just match what engine you are ordering. There is another type which does not have this. Okay, so if you use such type of gasket, that is not metal, that is made of some plastic. Okay, that insulate this from this. Okay, so this contains the your coils that need ground. Okay, so if you do that, just ground one of these screws. Okay, like I did this mine. Okay, either you can do this to this screw. Okay, right here, this is the shortest pathway. This is what Honda recommends. Okay, another thing, if you are gonna change your intake manifold for any reason, for example, if I remove this, this is a JDM or Asian Fit, you can say. This has a short hood, as I told. So the RBC manifold was this long. Okay, so this was, that was hitting this one. So I had to use the manifold which is the shortest tuner, which is the PRC. Okay, this is the RSX S manifold, and this is the shortest tuners of the K series. Okay, so I had to change that for that reason. But if you change the manifold for any reason, just check this screw out. Okay, that rubber, you see that rounded one, and look how close that is to that screw. Okay, that screw almost hitting it. This is even after I shaved this screw. I will show how did I this is. Okay,
so here is the solution for that problem. And this was the rubber squashed, and with time it was worn out. So this screw here, it touched with this intake manifold and it got short. And luckily alternator was not short, only the battery fuse was blown. this alternator fuse. Okay, so to fix that, just this is the alternator plastic cover. Just open these 1, 2, 3 screws. Okay, then just remove this plastic cover, and there is the bolt which we need to shorten this one and slightly this one, because we want to decrease the height. Okay, and I will tell you why we need to slightly grind this one too. Okay, after removing this bolt from here, this is easily removed. Just mark it up, just half a centimeter is enough. And this is after I grinded it with a grinder. Okay, I grinded this one too. Okay, look at how much long it is, and look at I did shorten. I grinded this one because when this screw height is short, the alternator wire is going through there. So if this screw was here, so this wire would have touched that and shortened the alternator. Okay, so when you short this one, just shorten this one too. Okay, so that the wire or the grip which is connected here does not touch here. Okay, and another thing, the wire which connects here goes in this direction, but to be safe, we want to go that in this direction. So just grind some plastic over here, this lower portion, just grind it over so that you change the direction of the wire and then just tighten the screw. Okay, so this will be our direction of the new wire. Okay, just put it back, and this is after the grinding, and this is just after putting back everything. Okay.
For example, in CRZ, look at that. How far is this rubber? Okay, this one alternator, there is the screw. Okay, and this is going in this direction. Okay, so this one I am telling you about. Okay, so if you change the manifold for any reason, just check this out. Okay.
Next is the knock sensor. If you want to use K21, no need to change the grip. If you have K24 one, just we will make the changes into the wiring, not this one. Okay,
on the back side, if you want to use a sandwich adapter plate to aftermarket oil pressure, oil temperature sensor, then use this one. And other is clean of the vtec solenoid, very important. This is after I cleaned it with the toothbrush and brake cleaner, very important, just don't forget. And then half shaft is installed, and then the lower dust cover is installed.
Okay, next one is the oil pump. This is after I remove the oil pump. This is K24 one. This is huge. This also have a balance shaft. After these spin double the speed of the engine. So if your engine is revving to 7000 rpm, these spin at 14000 rpm. If you try to rev it more, these will make a lot of froth and the air will be trapped in the oil. That is called cavitation. That is very dangerous. So I remove the balance shaft. That sacrifices slight comfort and slightly more vibration, but it is your choice. If you want to rev it to 8000 rpm, then just remove the balance shaft. This is I am talking about K24. K20s can rev easily up to 8200-8400. Okay, so this is mod for K24 if you want to rev it to the 8000. Next, I use this one. You can use any grinder like this. Okay, just this was the balance shaft. This is here I cut it. Okay, try to cut them as near as possible so you can save maximum mass. Okay, maximum mass we want to remove. And these were quite heavy. This is look how tidy the oil pump is now. Okay, but don't remove this part of the oil pump. This needs to bolt on. Okay, so after removed, I then reconnected the cover, put these screws back on. It was very easy, just took 10 minutes. Another important is when you do this mod, there is a hole in the block. Here it is, and this hole supplies this one on the clear view. This small supplies the oil to these balance shafts. Just we removed, okay, these one. So now these are removed, no oil needed. So just block this hole. If there is a screw, usually 10 mm, just remove that. If there is this thing, a dough like thing, then you put a screw in this, like this screw, and tighten that screw and pull that screw with a plier. Then this dough like thing will come out, and sometimes there are threads in that. Use some Honda bond and tighten it up, okay, that will be blocked. Okay, so now you will have more oil pressure and more high revs. Okay, 8000 revs easy, no need for the K20 oil pump. Okay,
if for any reason you remove the transmission and just label the holes on end, because every bolt length is different. Okay, label the bolts, okay, and the holes. Then and the top of the engine, you very important is you do the valve lash. Okay, and this is very easy. Just you will need a 10 mm key and a screwdriver and a feeler gauge, and this is the specs of the K series, and then should be done when engine is cold. Okay, And next is the, if you want to do the 50 degree VTC, then I am not going into the detail. You can either use a K21, but that is expensive, or you can modify your K24 one. Just you need to shave off some metal, but don't shave off 6 mm because that will advance it to 50 degree. A K24 50 degree is not safe, so I will not go into that detail.
The VTC actuator is installed on the camshaft. It has torqued before to the 83 foot pound with the torque wrench. Now it is, as you can see, it is unlocked. I can move it. Now I will rotate it clockwise and you will hear a click when it is locked. This. Now I can't move it. It's locked, okay? Now the VTC actuator is fitted. It's locked.
Okay guys, time has come for the actual setup to happen, not on the computer. Let's get to it. And before we do that, and just make sure before going to workshop, or you are, if you are doing the setup at home garage, the IMA battery should be full, because once these hybrid batteries are out of the car, they will start losing their life fast, okay? So with full, they will last longer and you can sell them off at a good price, okay? So try selling them within the month, because Honda says they lose their life fast after one. And then this was my donor car, which was taking supplies to the workshop and back home, because I am alone and I don't have some buddies to help me at home, plus I do not have an engine stand which will take out the engine and put back. So that's why I went to the workshop, okay? This contains some oil, coolant, filter, etc, etc, which is understandable. This contains some wiring stuff, the shifter, etc, etc, okay? Let's get to the swap. Okay, first we need to take out the engine. There are two approaches, okay? If you have access to a lift, your workshop has lift. For example, this is the Brian Gillespie from HAsport. He is taking out the engine from underneath the car by lifting the car. But in this approach, you have to remove whole of the lower subframe, okay? This, there's many bolts and strong bolts, okay? So this is cumbersome. I recommend, this is after they took the engine out, but I recommend other approach, which is just removing the cowl shield and just removing the radiator. Okay, that's all which CRZ needs. You already have disconnected the radiator. Just you need to open is one and two bolts and radiator will be out. Okay, so we will be doing this approach. Okay, and in Honda Fit, this is the JDM or Asian Fit. That's why the radiator is just near the engine and under this shield. So we will be removing this shield too, and sometime AC condenser should also be removed. Okay, so that we have more access in the engine bay. Okay, if you are JDM fit, then there won't be a problem. Only removing the radiator will suffice. Okay, next. Now cowl shield has been removed. Next we will remove the radiator, but before disconnecting this IMA wire, okay, this one, just turn off this button in the trunk. Okay, that will be safe and no one will get electrocuted. Next, the XLR being taken out, understood, because we have to take the engine out. Engine is being disconnected from all sides, the hoses, the wires, etc, etc. This is simply a self-explanatory process. Engine is almost to come out, and then the engine is out. These are the radiator line, fuel line, etc, etc. Then removing the IMA battery is simple. Just open the bolts and everything will be coming out. Okay, this is the red button I was talking about, this one. Okay, next is the delivering of the IMA wire. Okay, this is the underview of the CRZ. This is the fuel tank covered by plastic. Let us remove it. Okay, this tank is removed. Now look at that. In CRZ, the IMA wire is bypassing the fuel tank, so you may not need to open up the fuel tank. But in the Honda Fit Hybrid, this is passing beneath the fuel tanks, because the fuel tank is central in the Honda Fit. Okay, so in normal Honda Fit, this step is not needed. I am also covering the Honda Fit Hybrids too. Okay, so just open in the Honda Fit Hybrid, just open these two screws, let lower down this side of the fuel tank, tell someone to hold this. That's why I was telling to put less fuel before the swap and just deliver this IMA wire from beneath it. Okay, this is the wire and battery is delivered. Okay, and this was the hole where which wire was coming into the trunk. Just cover this up with some metal, etc. You can be creative over here as you like it, or you can leave them inside the car, because if you want to shift your battery in the trunk, and that will save a lot of space. I will explain this when we do this thing. Okay, just leave the IMA wire intact and that will save a lot of space in the engine bay, okay? And this is ideal if you are going turbo, because this will save a lot of space for the intercooler pipes to pass from here. But because if the battery is here, that the cold intake fitting is very difficult, the intercooler fitting is very difficult, okay? So I recommend shifting the battery to the trunk and leave the IMA wires here, and we will be covering this when the time comes, okay?
Okay guys, this will end the third part, and in the fourth part we will prepare our engine bay for the receiving the CRZ engine slightly modification, which will be needing. For example, if your chassis does not have this hole for the case for the HAsport mount, then we will be drilling that. Then I will be addressing whether if you has an automatic transmission, how to convert that to the manual, which shifter to use. Then I will be addressing whether the heater line will be compatible here, the radiator line will be compatible or not. Then on left side there is AC compressor hitting the body, how to trim that. And then we will be addressing whether the fuel line will connect to the CRZ fuel rail, and whether we need to change the brake booster or not, or its master cylinder, etc., etc. There will be so many things you should do to the engine bay before you put the new CRZ engine in it, okay? Because now you are preparing this whole thing to receive another engine, which it was not meant for, okay?
So we will be covering three routes the K20 Type R will be going into our Honda Fit. This is Honda Fit K20R will be going in this. Then the K24A2 will be going into our ZF1 chassis CRZ, and in ZF2 chassis CRZ K24A3 will be going in, okay? This was done in Malaysia. There is my friend Soon Zhang, and this is his ZF2 CRZ, and they use my help to do the swap. So I'll be touching ZF2 chassis from there. And interesting thing is, they copied this HAsport right mount, but they made OEM CRZ mount and made a bracket for other mounts, okay? This is their transmission mount. Look at that OEM CRZ mount they are using, and on the transmission this is again the OEM CRZ mount they are using, okay? But after 1 week this one broke, so that's why I'm telling you just use the original HAsport mounts, because now engine is supported by only 3 mounts. Originally it comes with 4 to 5 mounts, okay? But I will give you details if you want to cheap out, okay?
So stay tuned for that. Take care. Bye bye.